Welcome, dear veterinarian, to YouTube channel on channel name DRVET Dr. Vet. I am Dr. Praful Chandra Patel, Professor Veterinary Medicine. Today's lecture is on grain overload in ruminants. This video is in two parts because it is very long video and very important disease. So today we'll concern with the part one. There are many synonyms of this grain overload in ruminants. It is named as acid indigestion because on digestion that is production of lactic acid, and indigestion, that is why acid indigestion. It is also called as ruminal impaction because when the animal take excessive carbohydrate rich feed, there is impaction of the rumen, so ruminal impaction. It is also called as rumen acidosis, because here on digestion of carbohydrate food, there is production of lactic acid, the acid environment of the rumen, that's a rumen acidosis. Carbohydrate intoxication, because here there is excessive intake of carbohydrate rich food, and on digestion, there is production of lactic acid. Lactic acid is a chemical, and that chemical is absorbed into the circulation and produce a severe toxic symptoms. So carbohydrate intoxication. In some of the countries, acid indigestion is also observed with the severe laminitis also, and they named as a founder. Rumen overload, when animal take excessive carbohydrate food, the rumen become full of the fluid, and that's why it is called as rumen overload. Excessive eating of carbohydrate, rumen become full, that's why it is a rumen overload. Lactic acidosis, on digestion of carbohydrate, there is production of lactic acid. Rumen environment become acid, and this acid is absorbed into circulation. So it is called as lactic acidosis. Ruminant carbohydrate engorgement, excessive intake of carbohydrate engorges and impact the rumen. So ruminant carbohydrate engorgement. Grain engorgement, the rumen become impacted full because of excessive intake of the grain. So grain engorgement. There are more than 25-30 names, but these are the important names here, and its importance is discussed here. This lactic acidosis video is in two parts, part 1 and part 2. In part 1, we'll discuss definition, etiology and pathogenesis. This disease is very important, so I have discussed in detail in two parts. The disease produced acute, subacute or chronic symptoms in ruminants. Commonly affected cattle, buffalo, goat and sheep, the ruminants. Caused by a very important etiology, excessive feeding of carbohydrate rich diet. This is very important etiology. The disease is characterized by rumen hypomotility to atony, dehydration, acidemia, toxemia, diarrhea, depression, incoordination, recumbency, and in severe cases, death is observed. etiology of lactic acidosis. There is accidental sudden ingestion, or sometime the owner is very enthusiastic for overfeeding of large quantities of readily digestible and rapidly fermentable carbohydrate rich feed, such as carbohydrate rich grains, wheat, rice, bajra, jowar, barley and corn. So here large quantities of carbohydrate rich feed is an important etiology. Then another condition for this development of disease by unaccustomed animal, means when the animal are not used to take large quantities of carbohydrate food, they suffer more. Second condition, larger than normal amount of carbohydrate food. The finely ground or floor grain are more toxic because they provide more areas and surface for the digestion. Morbidity 10 to 50%. See the seriousness of disease. Case fatality 30 to 40% in treated cases and up to 90% in untreated cases. So disease is very severe. It produces severe symptom. Mortality is more, and frequently such cases are occurring in the field, especially after ripening of the crop on wheat or jowar or bajra, etc. The amount of carbohydrate feed required to produce acute illness depends on four conditions: kind or type of grain, its digestibility, how much fast it is fermented, so type of grain, previous experience or accustomed animals with carbohydrate rich grains, nutritional status and condition of animal, and nature of the ruminal flora. Adult ruminants accustomed to heavy carbohydrate diet develop only mild or moderate illness, whereas non-accustomed means they are not used to take more quantity of carbohydrate, may become acutely ill. Now how this happen, we'll understand this phenomena by help of this table. This column, daily consumption of quantity of carbohydrate feed. One animal take 10 kg, the other animal used to take 5 kg daily amount. So one animal is accustomed to take 10 kg daily, other animal is half, 5 kg. Second column, sudden consumption of quantity of carbohydrate feed. If the 10 kilogram animal is given 12 kilogram all of a sudden, and 5 kilogram consuming animal is given nearly double, 12 kilogram, quantity is the same. The third column, previous experience. Here, accustomed or unaccustomed, 10 kilogram, if that animal is given 12 kilogram, the animal is accustomed, not much difference. So here the animal manifest mild symptoms. But the animal regularly taking 5 kilogram, and if it is given 12 kilogram, nearly double, that animal is not accustomed, means unaccustomed to carbohydrate digestion, and that animal shows the severe symptoms. Pathogenesis of acid indigestion or grain overload. There are series of steps occurring. Increased gram-positive bacteria. Rumen content become acid. Animal shows dehydration. There is rumen hypomotility or complete atony. Inflammation of the ruminal wall, rumenitis. Absorption of lactic acid into the circulation, lactic acidosis and acidemia. Inflammation of the sensitive laminae of the foot, laminitis. Degeneration of central nervous system, polyencephalomalacia, and there are several pathophysiologic consequences of this severe disease. Now we see each of these in detail. First, increase gram-positive bacteria. On ingestion of large amount of or toxic amount of highly fermentable carbohydrate, it causes change in microbial population of rumen within few hours. The number of gram-positive bacteria such as Streptococcus bacilli, Lactobacilli increases suddenly because of the fast multiplication. So here gram-positive bacteria predominates. This gram-positive bacteria produce large quantities of lactic acid, LND lactic acid. Death of the gram-negative bacteria, there is release of endotoxin. This toxin is absorbed into circulation and toxicosis. Similarly, this lactic acid is also absorbed into circulation, produce lactidiosis. Second pathogenesis, acidic pH. Due to overproduction of lactic acid, the rumen pH falls below 5. This acidic pH destroys the normal protozoa of the rumen. It also destroys cellulose digesting organism. It also destroys lactate utilizing organism. And it impairs the ruminant motility, maybe hypomotility or atony. The third pathogenesis, dehydration. Lactic acid of the rumen increases the osmotic pressure of the rumen fluid. The rumen fluid becomes hypertonic, which results in accumulation of excessive quantities of fluid into the rumen from the circulation. So fluid is withdrawn from circulation into the rumen. And this causes fluid ruminal contents. And there is marked dehydration in the circulation. Dehydration leads to oliguria or anuria. In this dehydration, the water is lacking in the circulation. Water is not lost outside the body. Water is accumulated in the rumen. But there is manifestation of dehydration because of lack of water portion in the circulation. Fourth pathogenesis, rumen hypomotility. The lowering of the pH causes decrease in amplitude and frequency of rumen motility or atony. Fifth pathogenesis, ruminitis, inflammation of the wall of the rumen. Lower ruminal pH due to lactic acid causes a chemical ruminitis. Lactic acid is a chemical. When it come in contact with the rumen wall, it produces chemical ruminitis. After several days or weeks, the infection, the bacteria also come into contact with this ruminal wall, causing bacterial ruminitis. Then fungi also come in contact, produce mycotic ruminitis. Finally, there is necrosis and gangrene of the rumen wall, rupture of the rumen, and that produce peritonitis, leading to a very serious conditions. Sixth pathogenesis, lactic acidosis. Lactic acid is produced in rumen, and that lactic acid is absorbed, particularly delactated, into the circulation. This results in lactic acidosis and acidemia, and lactic acidosis also produces hepatic insufficiency and hepatitis also. The consequences, we have to treat this hepatitis and hepatic insufficiency also. Seventh pathogenesis, laminitis, inflammation of the sensitive laminae of the foot. Increase in toxic level produce histamines, and that histamine release cause vascular changes in lamina. This leads to laminitis. An animal shows lameness in all 4 feet. Eighth pathogenesis, polyencephalomalacia. Increase in thiaminase producing bacteria in the rumen, and this thiamine cause destruction of thiamine. So there is decrease in thiamine level in the rumen. Decrease of thiamine level in the circulation also, which produce necrosis of cerebral portion and cortical portion of the brain. And that leads to polyencephalomalacia. The production of ethanol, methanol, tyramine in the rumen also produce central nervous system depression. The last and the ninth pathogenesis is, there are many pathophysiologic consequences of lactic acidosis. There is acidosis and dehydration. This causes hemoconcentration. There is cardiovascular collapse leading to shock, renal failure, muscular weakness, and severe condition, death of the animal. Dear friend, thank you very much for observing grain overload in ruminant videos part 1. Next video will be grain overload in ruminants part 2. If you are not subscribed the channel, requested to subscribe the channel, requested to share to our veterinary friends for the services of animals. If you like, press like button. Thank you very much.